Folks, Buckshot LaFunk, ladies and gentlemen. Man, you see those guys out on the road, go see them. They are unbelievable. Folks, you can see my next guest, the co-host of the news magazine show, Hard Copy. Or you might spot her playing herself in the hit movie Casper. Ladies and gentlemen, Terry Murphy's with us. Terry Murphy, come on in.
I didn't want to leave them. Yeah. After all, the show's going away.
No, go ahead. Take what you need.
I needed to redecorate my office.
Unbelievable. Don't they have the huge budget on the Hard Copy? Don't you guys have the millions and millions of dollars that they spend? And they could have lamps like this. They probably have hundreds of these in the Hard Copy.
Do you want to know?
Toilet paper growing on trees.
That we can't have equal anymore.
You can't have equal?
Because Sweet and Low is cheaper.
At Hard Copy?
They took our Sweet and Low.
You're kidding.
Our Equal away and gave us.
Well, if that's not fodder for a story on Hard Copy, I don't know what is.
But anyway, this is not stealing. It's schnorring.
No, absolutely. Please, schnorr away.
And I'm appropriating this for. It's the same company anyway.
Exactly. Believe me, I'm sure you'll have my wardrobe in a couple of weeks. What's going on the Hard Copy? What are the big stories? What's the gangbuster stories? What's giving you the big ratings?
Well, right now, of course, every day OJ gives us a big rating, but fat people give us big ratings.
Watching or on?
On. Fat people. We have at least one fat person a month. The last one was a woman who lost 300 pounds and was still too fat to sit in the movie theater, and she brought her own chair and they wouldn't let her in, and we followed her to the theater and she says, "But I brought my own chair. Let me in." And they didn't, and she filed suit and settled out of court, and it got huge numbers, and she won.
Really? Yeah. That's, wow.
And then,
do you actually have meetings about this? Like, there'll be a guy in a room going, "You know what we need? Fat people."
Fat people. And Newt. And Newt.
Well, fat person. Newt Gingrich.
There you go.
There you go.
Combination.
Why does he bring in big ratings?
I do not know. You know, it doesn't matter what kind of story we do on him, we are always being accused.
What's the dirt on Newt Gingrich? Because I'm not a big fan of his.
Well,
I'm
the story we did tonight, we did one tonight. The story we did tonight was one prison administrator was forcing prison inmates to watch Newt on television all the time.
As a torture, right. Like Clockwork Orange,
They
pin their eyes open.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, I've seen that. And what does it make him do, go insane?
I don't know yet.
Yeah.
We'll find out.
Do you know
the
one about him and those dudes from the football team? And they went south of the border and naked pictures? Do you know that one?
God, where do I get the pictures? Well,
they're up near by the pillows, up in my dressing room. I have all the Newt Gingrich ones. I don't, do you
John,
ever...
John, I'm gonna miss you.
Really?
Oh, aren't you gonna miss John? You're so good.
Oh, sure, now.
Well, but we had fun when you came out to California.
I had a blast out there. I enjoyed myself out there. I enjoy, like, going out on the Hard Copy set because everybody is, when you walk in, everybody kind of turns and hides what they're working on. Like, it's a very secretive place, it seems. Everybody's,
well, it is. Well, it is. Because, you know, if you take the story like OJ, everybody tries to get their own special angle on it. I mean, and there was enough for everybody to go around. I mean, one of the programs had Cato Kaelin.
We had
Faye Resnick.
Do you guys ever feel bad? Like, when you do a story about somebody that's maybe kind of negative, do you ever think to yourself, boy, that might, knock that person on their butt. You know, do you ever, I wonder how it works with that stuff.
I don't know. You know, we're so preoccupied right now with the O.J. Simpson trial. It's been a long time. We used to do a lot of trailer park murders, a lot of sleazy people killing each other in trailer parks. I mean, that's what we were known for. I don't know. Do you remember that before we switched to
Do I remember
news?
That? No, my trailer park years are such a blur
murders?
That it's hard for me.
I mean, they were not attractive people. They were always killing each other, and that was our story. I mean, that's what we did. And then we changed to celebrity news, and our ratings got better.
Sure.
Fat people, John.
Imagine fat celebrities people. In trailer parks killing each other. I
mean, on
you guys
show,
have got huge.
This would have happened.
Oh, I think it's a little late.
Yeah.
Where did you start? Did you start locally?
I started in local news.
Yeah.
And it's a lot different doing tape, you know, than doing live. Because at least in tape, you can go back and you can, you know, redo your mistakes. But
in we'll be doing that tonight.
Do I have to stay? but in live television, you don't have a chance to do that. And I remember one time we had a little old lady who was a viewer who used to send us gifts every Valentine's Day.
Right.
Do I have time to tell this?
No.
No, should we take
it? No, don't.
And so one Valentine's Day, she sent us these little applique hearts that you could put on your lapel.
Sure.
So I put mine on, and then it was time for the weather. You know, the anchor woman always tosses the weather. And so I said, and now we're going to the weather. And Walt, I see you have your heart on. Well, that's about what I did too, because I didn't get it at first.
That's quite a bummer. Quite a mistake to make. That's I'm always there with the. Yeah. All right.
No comeback on that one.
No, I don't. I have no. Well, yes. That's wild. Yeah, I'm sorry. We won't be coming out to California, but hopefully I'll do something horrible and we'll work together again. You can report on me.
And you'll tell me when you quit smoking, because I know you were trying to quit smoking.
Absolutely, because I'll blow up and be a fat guy and
get the ratings.
Absolutely.
We're
going to take a commercial break. Terry's going to stick around. We'll be right back, everybody. See you in a little bit. Have you run? Can you do it? Hey, welcome back, everybody. Day two of the fire sale. Terry Murphy, thank you very much for joining us. And do I get the toilet paper back?
No, but I'm going to throw it.
Are you going to chuck it? All right, let it rip. Enjoy yourself.
Just
Happy Mischief
me how
Night.
To do it,
all right?
Right,
let it roll.
All right.
All right, let it. Oh. Three bounces and no, it could have worked out very nicely. Thanks very much. Want to thank Sherry Stringfield, Branford Marsalis, and Buckshot LaFunk. Have a great night, everybody, and we'll see you tomorrow.